Okie dokie, so. Mission inspiration. March. So I'm cheating. I'm starting with the map. And I'm gonna get. Oh, it's starting to rain again. Horrible day. I'm just gonna put some white paint on my finger and smush it around. I really don't know what I'm doing today. I know I need to get this film, so I'm making myself start it today. And I'm gonna just pop some paint down. And grab a stencil that I can pop that on. And then see what happens. I think straight line. Not for the straight line after that. I can't remember. Figure it out. So it's been a bit of an awkward day. I've had to nip back up to the shops again. I thought I'd done all my shopping yesterday, but I need to get something for tea tonight, so I've done that today. I've been on the Wii Fit. I'm starting to have a play with that. Try and get a little bit of gentle exercise in. And our washing machine's broke, so I'm having to do a little bit of laundry by hand. So, yeah. I think that's why I'm in a bit of a non-creative mood, but we'll get the juices flowing with this and then see where it goes. So I don't think I have any stencil out to hand. No. So I shall grab one. Give me a sec. Okay, so the next step actually says to add colour to a stencil, not necessarily pink. So I'm going to play with some inks today. Evergreen Bow Archival. And I bought these and I haven't used them yet, so I'm going to have a play and see how well these work, how I like them. There's a lot of flex in the handle. I'm not sure I like that. I feel like I might break it, to be honest. I'm a bit heavy-handed. Okay. Yeah. It's not too bad. Enjoying that. I don't know why I went for this colour. I just looked at my colours and went, that one looks nice. So why not? So let's just check. Make marks with a straight edge. This is also a new tool that I bought from Soster & Green. It's for, you know, cakes. Spread it nicely. So I did buy two. I bought one for cakes and one for art. So colour. There's like a peachy tone in there. Alrighty, let's just give that a bit of a shake. Pop a little bit of that down. smaller. That's glitchy as I remember it being, but there we go. So make marks. Should I just, I don't know, do I scrape? Do I dab? I think that's okay. Now I need to decide what I'm going to do as a quote. So once I figure that out, I will be back. So I've got these two little focal images. Trim down. Like this. Just get rid of that text up there. That's not straight at all. So I don't really know. Yeah, so I think I'm going to pop that there, and then I'm going to pop my quote on. I don't know what to use to write it though. It has to be handwritten apparently. I'm not sure I want to use black though, that's the thing. A green is cool. Oh, and a nice teal though. That might be nice. So I've got my quotes and things here. This is my Pinterest board full of quotes. I have dried it off the page. This one. It's gone off. So I think I'm going to write increase the intensity of colour up here because it seemed to be a little bit lacklustre when I first started. That's fine, here we go. So let's pop these down. This one's a sticker. Hopefully it won't take me an hour to get the backing off. Ta-da! And then we need a little glue for Madam there. It's just from a scrapbooking set. She was on a strip of little theatre images. Kind of works quite well because you've got the map, the world. Yeah. Happy coincidence there. Just wipe off some of that excess glue that's seeping out there. Right, what's the next step? I don't know. Let's have a peek. Draw circles or dots. I feel like dots might be interesting, but what, again, what colour? Do we use some yellow? Very bright yellow, I don't think I want that. It's got yellow here. Let's just add some doodly dots. Okay. Oh, I've got a peachy tone on here as well. Just thinking if I just make some random little peachy peaches. Okay. What's next? Outlines or shadows, and that's it. So let's use a brown bit for the bark, ink tint pencil, and a little shadow around her, and then I think I might add just a little bit of shadow around the whole page. To bring the eye in. So I'm just roughly scribbling a little bit. Now I'm not sure how well this is going to blend because there's a lot of just raw paper. But we'll find out. But now I just need a brush and a little bit of water. Let's just spray some water on this palette. Oh no. That was nearly a disaster. And then we'll go around the edges. Just a little bit. Just giving us a nice grungy vintage look. You can tell the difference where the paint is and where the raw paper is. That's okay, like I say, it's a nice grungy vintage look. Lovely. Oh, I'm going to pop a little bit. Bum, if I can find my pencils. Just a little bit underneath our little fairy deer. Although it has got that shiny border because it's of the way the sticker starts and ends. So it won't be as smooth as we would like, but we might. Yeah, I like that. There we go. And you can hardly see any of that because I'm screenshot. I'm too sorry. Yeah. My camera's still really wonky. I need to sort that out. Sorry. So that is Mission Inspiration for March. Did that really quick. Didn't think about it a lot. And I really like it actually. Very different to what I normally do. Sometimes you just gotta let go, just let it take on its own life form. Sometimes it works, sometimes you don't like it, but it's the process that counts, really, isn't it? So what's today's the 18th? Yes, tomorrow is Mothering Sunday in the UK, and my mother is away. She had her presents before she left. I'm going to buy her a nice bunch of flowers when she comes back. So, there we go. So, I hope you enjoyed that quick video. And I'll see you again soon. Might bring you along on my little journey. I've joined a swap for a journal, a travel journal. So, I might drag you along with me and we'll create that together. That sounds fun, doesn't it? Yes, of course it does. Sounds amazing. So hopefully see you then. Bye guys.